Good afternoon and welcome to the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional hosted by the University of North Georgia. Time for game one of this year's regional number one between the fourth seeded Georgia College or Catawba College Indians and the fifth seeded Georgia College Bobcats. Walker McCreary here live at Haynes and Carolyn Hill Stadium as the Indians take the field for the top of the first inning. They will be the home team and wearing the white uniforms today with the navy pants. Georgia College, the visitors on the scoreboard in the green tops and the white pants. Starting lineups, first for the fifth-seeded Georgia College Bobcats, who finished fourth in the Peach Belt Conference, coming to today's game with a 39-16 record. It'll be Daniel Bernstein to lead things off and play in center field. Bailey Hall bats second and plays short. Abby Leroy at second will bat third, and Lacey Najaffe, the catcher, will bat cleanup. She comes into today's game with a 19-game hitting streak. Kristen Brooks will bat fifth and play third. The first baseman, Faith Flanders, will bat sixth. Designated player, Taylor Campbell, seventh. Holland Corsi out in left will bat eighth. Caroline Snyder, the right fielder, will bat ninth. And in the circle for the Bobcats will be Marissa Boyette. For the Indians, fourth seeded, 25th in the country. They are 38-14 on the year and come into today's game as the SAC tournament champions. We'll set the defense for them in the top half of the inning. In left field is Lindsay Taylor. Out in center, Kristen Stinnard. In right is Holly Chandler. Sierra McCarthy at third. Gina Jerome at short. It is Caroline Turner at second and Morgan Brand at first. Behind the plate catching is Taylor Adams. Completing the battery from Carly Tysinger. The sun is coming out and we are underway here in Dahlonega. The first pitch from Tysinger is in there for a called strike. And we have officially started the road to Denver. Host of the Division II softball championships this year. Tysinger in the circle, winds and delivers. Misses outside on that one. Oh, it caught the outside corner for strike two. A little bit of a delayed call behind the plate. 0-2 is the count. We'll hit Tysinger's stats in just a moment. No balls and two strikes. Tysinger out of her windup. Here's the pitch. That caught the zone, strike three. Down goes Bernstein with strikes. The 399th strikeout this season for Carly Tysinger, who comes into today 31-9 overall with a .96 ERA. 37 complete games, 39 starts, 10 shutouts in 278 innings of work. She's struck out now 399 opponents, walked just 60. First pitch to Bailey Hall is chopped right back to Tysinger. She'll backhand, throw over to first for out number two. So Bernstein down on strikes, Hall down on the first pitch, and that brings up Abby Leroy. Leroy, first team all Peach Belt Conference this year. Batting 364. 19 doubles leads the Peach Belt Conference this season. First pitch strike, as Tysinger has pitched nothing but strikes thus far. The 0-1 pitch. Low and outside, 1-1. Officials for game number one of the 2016 Southeast Regional number one. Jill Poole behind the plate. Monique McMurray at first and Melvin Clark out third. The 1-1. Popped foul. Over in the terrace section of Haynes and Carolyn Hill Stadium. 205 down the lines, 210 in the alleys, 220. To straightaway center. Center field from left center to right center for the most part. A 2-foot heightening of the wall. The 1-2's outside, 2-2. The wall is 6 feet in right field, past right center, and the same in left to left center, and then it increases to 8 feet tall in straightaway center. The 2-2 pitch fouled off by number two. These two teams met back on February 20th, a 3-2 win for Catawba. It was a game where both teams came in undefeated. Georgia College was the ninth-ranked team in the nation. And Catawba jumped out to a 3-0 lead and held on late despite committing three errors in the game. The 2-2 pitch chopped right at the plate, fielded by the catcher, Adams, and thrown over to first to Brand for out number three. The Bobcats go quietly in the first. We head to the bottom half, scoreless. You are watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional from Dahlonega on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
Strength, power, and speed of elite student athletes will be on display. The sights, the sounds, the intensity of six NCAA championship competitions. It all comes down to this moment, and the winners take it all. Be there to share the experience with your family and friends. The 2016 NCAA Division II Spring National Championship Festival, May 16th through the 21st in Denver. Visit ncaa.com/tickets to score your championship experience today.
I coined my definition of success in 1934. My definition of success is peace of mind attained only through self-satisfaction in knowing you made the effort to do the best of which you're capable. It's like reputation and character. Reputation is what others perceive you to be. Character is what you are.
Scoreless through the top of the first here in Dahlonega as part of game number one of the Southeast Regional, hosted by the University of North Georgia. For Catawba, it will be Turner Stinnard Shoemaker, who's the designated player, Jerome Brand Tysinger, Adams Chandler, and Taylor. Shoemaker will be batting for the third baseman, McCarthy. For Georgia College out in the field, Corsi out in left, Bernstein in center, Snyder in right. Brooks and Hall on the left side, Leroy and Flanders on the right. The Jaffe behind the plate catching for Marissa Boyette. We'll hit Boyette's stats here momentarily as she fires a first pitch strike to Caroline Turner, who's batting 278 this year. Boyette 12-6 on the year, 3-3 ERA. She has 111 strikeouts, and she took the loss against Catawba back on February 20th. In that game, Boyette gave up all three runs, 10 hits, and a complete game. Struck out 9 Indians, though, so that is a good sign for Georgia College. She has shown the ability to strike out the Indians this season. The 1-1 is low, 2-1. Tysinger, of course, earned the win in that game, striking out 10 in the process. And she was able to hold Georgia College to just 3 hits on the day. She was hampered by 3 Indian errors in that game, but she was able to do just enough down the stretch. 3-1 now the count to Caroline Turner, who on the year, 2 home runs, a couple triples as well, 17 runs batted in. She'll shoot this one to right center. It's going to get down, bounce against the wall. Gets past the center fielder, Bernstein, who couldn't field it cleanly. Here comes a play over to third, and that's overthrown. Good job backing up over there, though, by the left fielder, Holland Corsi. Otherwise, that is sailing out of Haynes and Carolyn Hill Stadium, and that will be called a triple. So the third triple of the year for Caroline Turner, and Kristen Stinnard has a prime opportunity to put the first runs on the board. And when Catawba scores first, well, let's just say that they are near perfect. 29-4 on the year when they score first, 16-2 when they score in the first inning. The bunt laid down nicely. Play at the plate is going to be out. says Jill Poole. Fielder's choice on the play. So Catherine Shoemaker will step in. And immediately, Coach Jamie Gradecki going to go out to the circle to have a word with her entire defense. Let's take a look at that last play here on our NCAA replay. The bunt laid down nicely. It's just a little too strong, though. Boyette thinks about going to first and gets to home just in time there to make the play, and now Coach Gradecki is trying to settle down this Georgia College team, who was here last year in the Super Regional against North Georgia, and had it not been for a Tiffany Burns grand slam in the 12th inning of game one of that Super Regional, Georgia College might have been taking a trip to Oklahoma last year. Instead, the Nighthawks of North Georgia, who we will see in our second game of our doubleheader, went to Oklahoma City and went on to win the national championship. First pitch to Catherine Shoemaker is fouled off down the third baseline, 0-1. Shoemaker 299 on the year with two home runs, 21 RBI. Stinnered on the base paths, dangerous, and that might have been why Gradecki went out to the circle. 15 of 15 this year, Stinnert is stealing bases. Here's the 0-1 pitch in the dirt, 1-1. A field turf surface here in Dahlonega, all artificial turf, including in the circle. As the wind has started to settle down a little bit, here's the 1-1. Popped up down the left field line, giving chase is Holland Corsi, and she will make the catch, hitting up against the wall, tagging up as Stinnert, moving up to second on the play. So two down in the inning. Here's Jerome, first pitch, misses low, 1-0. The 1-0 pitch, missed low and outside as well. Pitch, pop down the right field line. It's going to get out of play. 2-1. Two balls and a strike to Jerome, who's hitting 340 on the year. Four home runs, 32 runs batted in. She'll foul this one off at the plate, 2-2. The 2-2 pitch, grounded to short. Fielding and throwing over for out number three, and the side is retired. Heading to the second, no score here in Dahlonega. You're watching the 2016 Division II Southeast Regional from Dahlonega on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
It's on us, all of us, to make sexual assault unacceptable.
Anyone can be the victim. Everyone can be the solution. It's on us to stand up and not stand by. Because when you're a victim of sexual assault, no one should stand alone.
It's on us!
It starts right when you hit the court. You imagine your finest moment. The game-winning shot that gets you to the dance. A monster dunk or no-look pass and cutting down the net. Sports lets us dream of our own success and prepare us for our finest moments on and off the court.
No score as we head to the top of the second inning. It will be 4, 5, and 6 due up for Georgia College with Najafi leading things off against Carly Tysinger, first team NFCA All-Region this year. She goes into her wind. Here's the first pitch to Najafi, high in the air to deep left field. Back it goes, it's out of here. Lacey Najafi, now a 20-game hitting streak, and she puts Georgia College on the board first. It's 1-0 Bobcats. And she'll come around, greeted by her team. And that's how to start a regional, ladies and gentlemen. Kristen Brooks will now step in. That's the 6th home run of the year for Najafi. First pitch to Brooks, low and inside. Georgia College does pretty well when they score first, 30-3 on the year when scoring the game's first run. There's the 1-0 pitch, fouled off toward the Catawba dugout. Had some rain come through Dahlonega prior to the start of today's game, pushing our first pitch back 40 minutes due to lightning in the area. That one popped up. It's going to bounce foul right off the foul line and rolls back behind home plate. 1-2 now to the third baseman, Kristen Brooks, 327 on the year. 8 home runs, 41 runs batted in. Now the sun has come out. The wind is still blowing a little bit from left to right on your screens. Here's the 1-2 pitch, swung on and missed. Second strikeout of the day for Carly Tysinger. Now 400 strikeouts on the year. Impressive, to say the least. That'll bring the first baseman, Faith Flanders, to the plate. All Peach Belt Conference first team. Player of the week for the conference back at the beginning of March. First pitch ball. Flanders leads the Peach Belt and runs batted in this year with 55, 20th in Division II. The junior from Dublin, an exercise science major. Tysinger winds the 2-0 pitch. Misses low and inside 3-0 as Tysinger's being careful not to leave anything just hanging over the plate against this dangerous first baseman, Faith Flanders. 16 doubles on the year, 7 home runs. Batting .377. As that one's in there for a strike, Flanders thought that it was ball 4. She'll come back and face a 3-1 pitch from Carly Tysinger. The 3-1. That one's outside. A walk to Faith Flanders. the 13th walk that she's drawn this year. Designated player Taylor Campbell will be next up. 285 on the year. 13 doubles, 8 home runs, 39 runs batted in. First pitch popped up, foul ground, short of third base. It's McCarthy coming over to make the play for out number 2. Holland Corsi will step in. First pitch that she will face from Tysinger is on the outside corner for strike one. Corsi, 267 on the year. A home run and 16 runs batted in. Tysinger into her wind. Here is the 0-1 pitch. It's in the dirt. Flanders going to try and advance to second. Will do so standing. Pass ball on the play is how it will be ruled. A ball and a strike to Corsi, who's going to try and put another run on the board for the Bobcats. The 1-1 fouled out of play, 1-2. Bobcats 1-1 on this field this year. In the doubleheader that was played against North Georgia on national television. On ESPN3, they won game 2 of that doubleheader. That one fouled off by Corsi, still 1-2. Lost game 1, 10-5. Before rebounding and winning game 2, 3-2. A ball and 2 strikes to Holland Corsi. Here's the pitch. Caught the zone, strike 3, and down goes Corsi. But the damage done in the first. It was Lacey Najafi going yard to left field. It's 1-0 Bobcats. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional from Dahlonega on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
Change is constant. Technologies, careers, society. Georgia College is not about landing your first job. It's about preparing for success in a changing world. From the moment you step on campus, you have an immediate sense of belonging. At Georgia College, learning takes place all around us. Our students are critical thinkers, ready to graduate into a complex world. Georgia College, your public liberal arts university.
Nothing Bobcats as we head to the bottom half of the second inning here in Dahlonega. Game 1 of the Southeast Regional. Game 2 will feature the top-seeded Nighthawks of North Georgia taking on the 8th-seeded Mountain Lions of Young Harris. It will be the 5, 6, and 7 hitters for Catawba to lead things off. Morgan Brand, then the pitcher Carly Tysinger, and the catcher Taylor Adams due up for the Indians. Head coach Nan Whitley of Catawba. As Catawba will look to answer here in the second inning. First pitch fouled off by Brand for strike 1. 289 on the year for the senior Morgan Brand. 8 home runs leads the team. She has 5 doubles as well. Low and outside on that one. 1-1 the count. These two teams were both ranked in the top 10 in the nation at some point this year. In fact, three of the four teams at this regional can boast that they were in the top 10 at some point. All four can boast that they were in the top 20. A very tough regional. Whoever comes out of this regional will certainly be battle tested. The 2-1 pitch from Boyette's. High in the air, shallow center field. Coming on is Bernstein. It'll be the second baseman, though, to field Leroy in the infield as the wind knocked that one down. One out in the inning. That brings Carly Tysinger to the plate. She'll try and help her own cause. She bats 209 on the year. She does have two home runs, 15 runs batted in. The wind and the pitch, it catches the outside corner for strike one. The lights are on here at Hill Stadium. The 0-1 pitch, breaking ball misses short of the plate, 1-1. Georgia College on the Najafi home run. That's how we got to this score if you're just joining us. That one on the inside corner, 1-2. And I'll tell you, the home run was an absolute no-doubter. One ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Breaking ball in the dirt, 2-2. North Georgia Nighthawks sitting to the right of our broadcast position. They're getting ready for their first game of the regional a little bit later tonight. Tysinger fouls that one over the Catawba bullpen. Still 2-2. Great crowd already showing up for this game here in Dahlonega. The 2-2 pitch coming. Grounded to short. Hall fields, throws over to Flanders for out number two. Taylor Adams will step in next, the catcher. Bats 222 on the year. A home run and 10 RBI. First pitch, check swing, caught the bat, fielded, throwing over and making the play is Adams for out number three. We head to the third here in Dahlonega, Georgia College 1, Catawba nothing. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional from Dahlonega here on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
This is why we love sports. It's in the way they play, free from the pressures and all the money talk. Playing for simply the love of the game, where everyone has a shot at their definition of success on and off the field. This is what we love about sports and what we can still love about college sports.
Catawba's Carly Tysinger finishing her warm-up tosses, and we are almost set for the start of the second inning here in the third inning here in Dahlonega. 1-0 Bobcats. It will be Corsi or rather Snyder, Bernstein Hall, to lead things off. So Snyder, batting 354 this year as a freshman. First pitch misses 1-0. She's hitting 407 over the past 10 games with 6 RBI and 4 runs. Georgia College is 15-4 when she's in the starting lineup. Here's the 1-0 pitch inside. 2-0. As you can see, the sun peeking out through the clouds. It's a cloudy day in the low 50s here in Dahlonega. The 2-0 pitch. Outside, 3-0. Cool weather for May here in the North Georgia Mountains. We expect it to come back up into the 70s before the weekend is said and done. The 3-0 pitch caught the zone. Snyder didn't quite agree with that one. She'll come back to the left-handed batter's box. Ty Singer out of the wind. Here's the 3-1. Inside corner. 3-2 the count. Ty Singer winds. That ball is foul as it was just outside of third base. It was close, but it just went foul. Again, the payoff pitch from Ty Singer. Grounded to first. Bran Fields will step on first herself for out number one. Circles the lineup back over. That'll bring Bernstein to the plate. 0-1. Struck out looking to lead off the game. She'll offer a bunt and miss 0-1. Infield playing in, the third baseman McCarthy, the second baseman Turner, expecting either a slap hit or a slap bunt. Bunt laid down, it'll go foul. It's now 0-2. You'll see this in softball, that the second baseman will come in to field the bunt on the right side, allowing the first baseman to stay put at first base on a close play, instead of having the second baseman run over and try and get to the base in time. The 0-2 swung on and missed. Two down in the inning, as that is the fourth strikeout of the day for Ty Singer. Brings Bailey Hall back up to the plate. She's 0-1, grounded out to Ty Singer on one pitch. Ty Singer winds and delivers. Again, right back to Ty Singer. She will field and go over for out number three. We're through 2.5 here in game number one of the Southeast Regional. It's Georgia College 1, Catawba nothing. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional live from Dahlonega here on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
The 2017 NCAA Final Four, the ultimate experience for college basketball fans. The passion, the spectacle, and the pageantry of college basketball's premier event. Make your plans now to head to Phoenix for the 2017 NCAA Final Four, April 1st and 3rd at University of Phoenix Stadium. Visit ncaa.com/mbbtickets to apply for your seats today.
Strength, power, and speed of elite student athletes will be on display. The sights, the sounds, the intensity of six NCAA championship competitions. It all comes down to this moment, and the winners take it all. Be there to share the experience with your family and friends. The 2016 NCAA Division II Spring National Championship Festival, May 16th through the 21st in Denver. Visit ncaa.com/tickets to score your championship experience today.
Two and a half in the books here in Dahlonega. Georgia College up on the Najafi home run in the second. Leading off for Catawba will be Holly Chandler. It'll be Chandler, Taylor, and then the lineup will flip. Back to Caroline Turner. Chandler batting right at the Mendoza line, 200 on the year. She does have four triples. Slapped into center. Bernstein a couple of steps into the NG logo for out number one. Lindsay Taylor will now step in, the freshman hitting 359 on the year. 14 of 39. She's played in 20 games. This is her 21st and her 16th start of the year. First pitch in there for a called strike. Boyette dealing now. As she's gotten Catawba, other than the triple to lead off the game, she's retired seven straight. The 0-1 fouled off at the plate, 0-2. A leadoff triple, but then on a bunt try by Kristen Stennard, Boyette was able to field it quickly. Acted like she was going to go to first. It was more of a fake as then Caroline Turner broke for home, and she was dead to rights at that point. The 0-2 outside, 1-2. Slight breeze comes through the grandstands here at the hill. The 1-2 pitch. Just missed low and outside, 2-2. Lindsay Taylor, the freshman left fielder. Here's the 2-2. Shot to center field. Bernstein was coming in. It'll get all the way to the wall. Taylor hesitated at second. She'll slide in head first into third. Was she able to hold on to the base? No, she wasn't. Called out on the play as she was unable to hold the base. I think if she would have been able to hold the base, she would have been safe. Officially ruled a double. So the second hit of the day for Catawba, but a base runner is nowhere to be found. She could not hold onto the base. First pitch high to Caroline Turner for a ball. Tripled to lead off the game for the Indians, then was thrown out at the plate. The 1-0 pitch misses as well, 2-0. Bernstein was coming in on the play, and Lindsay Taylor really just got a hold of that one. The 2-0 pitch. Popped foul. Out of play. 2-1. Wind starts to pick up, blowing in from right field. The 2-1 pitch. Just missed outside. 3-1. The Bobcat faithful here in Dahlonega thought that one should have been called a strike. Voice their disapproval. But Boyette back to work. Here's the 3-1. Line down the left field line. It'll go foul. And we will have a full count pitch coming. Three balls and two strikes. Boyette toes the rubber. Gets the sign from Najafi, winds and delivers. And a walk drawn by Caroline Turner. Walk number 24 of the year that Turner has drawn. Walk number 47 Boyette has given. Center fielder Stinnard will step in. Reached on a fielder's choice back in the first. She'll foul this one straight back into the netting, 0-1. The outfield for the Bobcats playing in a slight shift to left. The 0-1. Fouled down the third baseline. No balls and two strikes. Stinnard looking to slap, so you would think that she's going to try and go to the third base side. And to adjust to that, Brooks is going to hug that third base line. The shortstop, Hall, going to shift over as well. Pitch misses low and outside. 1-2 the count. The left fielder, Holland Corsi, is playing pretty close to the line and left as well. The 1-2 pitch, chopped to the left side. Hall tried the backhand, couldn't get it. Rounding second, going to third on the play was Caroline Turner. She will reach third, and on the play, Stinnard will advance to second. Will be ruled a single. So here the Indians are threatening in the bottom of the third with two down for Catherine Shoemaker. Shoemaker has brought home 21 Indian runs this year. And with a base hit, she could put Catawba on top here in the regional round of the NCAA Softball Championships. And Jamie Gradecki is going to, looks like, go to the bullpen, and that's exactly what she will do. We will take a break here in Dahlonega as the Bobcats are going to make a pitching change. When we return, we'll introduce you to the new Bobcat pitcher. We'll make sure it's a pitching change first and not just a normal substitution. It will be a pitching change, so we will take a break here in Dahlonega. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional from Dahlonega here on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
Strength, power, and speed of elite student athletes will be on display. The sights, the sounds, the intensity of six NCAA championship competitions. It all comes down to this moment, and the winners take it all. Be there to share the experience with your family and friends. The 2016 NCAA Division II Spring National Championship Festival, May 16th through the 21st in Denver. Visit ncaa.com/tickets to score your championship experience today.
Georgia College new pitcher is Carly Lewis, a second team NFCA All-Region junior righty, 20-9 on the year, a 1.66 ERA. She has 145 strikeouts on the year to just 61 walks. Batters 227 against her And she's in a bit of a pickle here, as there are two Indians on with two outs and just a one-run lead. The Indians have not seen Carly Lewis this year. Boyette pitched the complete game back in February. First pitch from Lewis is low and outside, 1-0. Catherine Shoemaker earlier today flew out to left. It was actually a foul out. Here's the 1-0 pitch. It missed as well, 2-0. There is an empty base for Shoemaker, but then you bring Gina Girone to the plate, who is pretty dangerous as well, 32 RBI on the year. That leads the Indians team. They won the SAC tournament last week, now 2-1 on Shoemaker. Had to go to a decisive game against Lenore Ryan and won that one to earn the automatic bid out of the SAC. Two balls and a strike. The wind in the pitch from Carly Lewis, grounded to short. Hall, Fields, throws over to first. Four out number three in Georgia College is out of danger here in the third. We head to the fourth. Bobcats leading 1-0. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional live from Dahlonega on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
It's on us, all of us, to make sexual assault unacceptable.
Here are a few tips that can help. Talk to your friends honestly and openly about sexual assault.
Don't be a bystander. If you see something, intervene in any way you can.
Be direct. Ask someone who looks like they may need help if they're okay.
It's on us!
They told me a bottle couldn't dream. That I would never become a superhero. But I learned how to fly. Just to come back in a new disguise. And be the hero that I've always wanted to be.
One nothing Georgia College as we head to the fourth inning. Here in Dahlonega, it will be Abby Leroy, Lacey Najaffe, and Kristen Brooks to lead things off. Leroy stepping in. First pitch high and outside. Ball one. Grounded out in her first plate appearance. Here's the 1-0. Going outside, 2-0. Ty Singer still in the circle. She goes into her wind, and the 2-0 pitch popped up down the third baseline. It will get into the Catawba bullpen. Two balls and a strike. Ty Singer facing Abby Leroy. That pitch misses as well, 3-1. The senior second baseman, Abby Leroy, watches 3-1. Now it's 3-2. Georgia College's all-time leader in RBI and doubles in her career, 167 RBI, 64 doubles. She leads the Peach Belt in doubles this year with 19. That one down the left field line. Will it be 21 as she already doubled earlier today? And that's the first double of the day on the wrong line there. on my score sheet. So the 20th double of the year for Abby Leroy. She put it down the left field line. The left fielder Taylor got over to cut it off quickly. Otherwise, Leroy might have stretched that one to three. Now Najafi will step in. And she made some noise her first at bat. First pitch to her. Caught the high outside corner for strike one. She belted one to left field. Over on the hill, right out there and left. The 0-1 pitch. Swung on and fouled off, 0-2. Georgia College leading 1-0. Here in the top of the fourth. When they're leading after three innings, they're 30-1 on the year. The 0-2 fouled off. We'll do another 0-2 pitch momentarily. If they can get through the fourth inning with a lead, they are 31-0. They have never lost when leading after four innings. Pitch. That bounced off home plate, but I think it's going to be foul, and yes it is, as nobody touched it. The third baseman, McCarthy, was lucky not to get her glove on that one, as it took a really funny bounce after it hit off home plate. And kind of did a little like a top does, and just spun right out of play. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. High in the air behind home plate. It will get out of play. And we'll do another 0-2 pitch. Young Harris is here at Haynes and Carolyn Hill Stadium. They're standing up on the ridge in left field as Najafi grounds to second. Turner Fields tosses over to Brand for the out. Advancing to third on the play, though, is Leroy. And Tysinger in a little bit of danger here as Kristen Brooks will step in. To finish the thought, young Harris up on the ridge in left field to take in a little bit of the game, though, will be making their first ever NCAA tournament appearance in game two of our doubleheader, taking on the Nighthawks of North Georgia. One out in the inning, Kristen Brooks standing in, struck out in the second. First pitch, swung on and missed. 0-1. Brooks led the Peach Belt Conference in being hit by a pitch. She did so 16 times this year. She'll ground this one to third. Fielding and throwing is McCarthy to get the out. Leroy having to stay put. Faith Flanders will step in next. Second team NFCA All-Region. She has 14 multi-RBI games this year. She had 6 RBI against Benedict off of two home runs back on March the 4th at the Shaw University Classic. A 9-0 win for the Bobcats in that one. And she brought home 6 of those runs. Impressive. The 1-0 pitch. Low and inside, 2-0. Again, Tysinger being careful not to give
Flanders anything on a silver platter here. Walked Flanders in her first plate appearance, the 2-0. Inside 3-0. Ty Singer winds, and the 3-0 pitch. Caught the inside corner, 3-1. Campbell on deck, should she get an opportunity here in the fourth. The 3-1 pitch, grounded. It'll be fielded fair, and stepping on the bag is Brand. Four out number three. Catawba gets out of a big jam in the fourth. We head to the bottom half. We are halfway home in Dahlonega. It's 1-0 Georgia College. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional from Dahlonega on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
The road to national championships runs through NCAA.com. And whether you follow one college team or all of them, it's never been easier to get the content you want all in one place. With live broadcasts of multiple championships across all divisions. With exclusive access.
This would be a great day to play perfect, wouldn't it?
And highlights for every single championship. Stay in the game all season long with NCAA.com, the home of college sports.
They'll test you. Try to break your will. But however loud the loudness gets, however many cheese puffs may fly, you're the driver, the one in control. Stand firm. Just wait. And move only when you hear the click that says they're buckled in for the drive. Never give up till they buckle up.
To the top of the, or to the bottom rather, of the fourth we go. It is 1-0 in favor of the Bobcats of Georgia College, fifth seeded in the Southeast region. Gina Jerome will lead things off. It'll be 4, 5, and 6 due up here in the inning facing Carly Lewis. Jerome grounds to second. Leroy Fields throws over to Flanders at first for out number one. One pitch, one out. And that means that Morgan Brand will step in next. Brand popped out her first plate appearance. Carly Lewis rolls one to home plate on that one, 1-0. Looked like it might have slipped out of the hand just a little early. A ball and no strikes to Morgan Brand. Behind first base, it will bounce foul as Flanders couldn't get there quite in time. 1-1. A ball and a strike, one out. Number one at the plate, it's 1-0 Bobcats. The Indians looking to answer. The 1-1 pitch. Breaking ball, just missed, 2-1. Here's the 2-1. Shot towards second, fielding and throwing over. I don't think she needed to, as it is an official line out to the second baseman, Leroy, for out number two. So Ty Singer, again looking to try and help her own cause. She's down 1-0. Pitched very well, only giving up two hits and a couple of walks. But one of those hits was a long ball. The 1-0 pitch. Inside, 2-0. Lewis winds and finds the inside corner, 2-1. Carly Lewis to Carly Tysinger. A matchup of pitchers here in Dahlonega. The 2-1 inside, 3-1. Two down in the inning. Lewis winds and delivers. Popped up. Leroy will make the play for out number three. 1-2-3 go the Bobcats, or the Indians rather, in the fourth. We head to the fifth. Georgia College 1, Catawba 0. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional, live from Dahlonega, here on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
Technologies, careers, society, it is impossible to predict the future. The jobs of tomorrow may not even exist today. At Georgia College, you will learn to be a critical thinker, to develop new ideas and out-of-the-box solutions, because those are the kind of lifelong skills you'll need in a rapidly changing world. The way we see it, it's not really about what you know, it's about how you think. Georgia College, your public liberal arts university.
Campbell Corsi Snyder due up here in the inning for the Bobcats, who lead 1-0. One run off two hits for Georgia College. No runs off three hits for Catawba. Both pitchers, well, really all three pitchers, have pitched well in this game. But the lone run from Najafi is what's on the scoreboard, and it is the difference. Tysinger. Out of the wind, first pitch misses low to Taylor Campbell, who is 0-1 on the day. Here's the 1-0 pitch, fouled off. One and one. Georgia College has never blown a lead after the fourth inning. Catawba will look to answer or to change that statistic throughout the rest of the game. Now 1-2. The 1-2 pitch. That's going to get out of play. We'll do another 1-2. A ball and two strikes. Tysinger winds and delivers. Swung on and missed. Tysinger with her fifth strikeout of the game. So Corsi will step in. One of those five strikeouts for Tysinger. Carly misses, or caught the outside corner, rather. Hard to tell from my angle. I'm not sitting right behind home plate. I'm off to the right of your angle. So the 0-1. This is outside. 1-1. Ty Singer is going to get a new softball. Regional round today, tomorrow, and Saturday across the nation. The 1-1. Line to third. Nice catch over there by McCarthy for out number two. Super regional round is next Wednesday and Thursday before the softball championships start in just over a week and a half. First pitch to Chandler, shot right back up to center field, base hit. Third hit of the day for the Bobcats. As Snyder gets Georgia College back to the top of the lineup in Bernstein. Bernstein yet to put one in play today. She struck out twice. First pitch, ball. That one in there, 1-1. Bernstein gonna look to slap it. As the Bobcats looking to hold on to this 1-0 lead. They win, they play at noon tomorrow. The loser of this game will play at 2:30. The 1-1 pitch lined, and it will be fair as the third baseman McCarthy couldn't handle it. It will be a hit. It is a double. So the Bobcats in business here in the fifth inning as Bailey Hall will step in. She's 0-2 today, but she does have a chance to extend this Bobcat lead. Of course, the winner of this game will play the winner of our next game at noon. The loser of this game will play the loser of game number two in an elimination game tomorrow at 2:30. As that one hit Bailey Hall right in the knee, she will walk that one down the first base line. Jill Poole gonna walk halfway with her. We'll see if Bailey's okay. She starts to jog a little bit. She'll jog down the right field line just a little bit and then come on back to first. So the bases are loaded with two outs for Abby Leroy. Jamie Gradecki asking Bailey Hall if she's okay. She could be run for here and then re-entered into the game, but if you do that, you lose A, a pinch runner, and B, the ability to take Bailey out later and re-enter her into the lineup if that were to be the case. So Ty Singer in some danger here in the fifth. She's already down 1-0. She's facing Leroy, who doubled in her last plate appearance. And she's got the bases full on top of that. Now 2-0. And the lineup gets no easier as Najafi is on deck, who homered back in the second. The 2-0 pitch, fouled out of play.
Hey,
Two balls and a strike. To the senior, Leroy. Tysinger winds and delivers. Missed high, 3-1. Expect a hitter's pitch here. Tysinger into her windup. Here's the pitch. Breaking ball misses high. And a run will be walked home here. It's 2-0 Bobcats. The base is still full for Najafi. And Catawba going to go out for a mound visit. Georgia College on the year, 39-16 coming in. They started the year on an 11-game winning streak before taking their first loss of the year to Catawba. Also had winning streaks mixed into the middle of their year, won six straight from March 5th to March 12th. And then near the end of the season, went on a nice little winning streak. Won seven in a row in Peach Belt Conference play, sweeping Georgia Southwestern, Montevallo, and then Albany State out of conference before splitting with Lander to end that winning streak. They were one and done, though, in the Peach Belt Conference tournament, losing to UNC Pembroke 5-0 in the quarterfinal. So Najafi stands in. First pitch, swung on and missed. 13 multi-hit games, first team all-conference, the 5'5 senior from Swanee, prepped at North Gwinnett. Best defensive catcher in Georgia College history. She has four pickoffs. She's caught 12 runners stealing this year. Ball and a strike to her. Here's the pitch. Swung on and missed. A ball and two strikes. Tysinger. Ahead in the count, here's the 1-2. Fouled off. We're in the top of the fifth. Georgia College has put up another run. It's 2-0. The wind and the pitch outside, 2-2. Tysinger, again in her windup. She'll bounce that one to the plate, and the count is full. The runners will be off with the pitch here. The wind picks up momentarily. Tysinger, the payoff pitch to Najafi. Fouled off down the first baseline. We will do it again. Runner's going to get some exercise here. It's Bernstein at third, Hall at second, Leroy at first. And Kristen Brooks stands on deck, hoping to get an opportunity to continue to add to this Bobcat lead. The payoff pitch swung on and missed, and Tysinger sits down to Jaffe on strikes to get out of the inning. Bobcats leave three stranded in the fifth. Get one across, though. It's 2-0 Georgia College. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional live from Dahlonega on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
Strength, speed, and power of elite student athletes will be on display. The sights, the sounds, the intensity of NCAA championship action. It all comes down to this moment. Only the best teams advance to this level. Be there to share the experience with your family and friends. The 2016 NCAA Women's College World Series. June 2nd through the 8th at ASA Hall of Fame Stadium, OGE Energy Field in Oklahoma City. Visit NCAA.com/WCWS to secure your championship experience today.
Alvin and the Chipmunks want to remind you, bacteria can hide in food and make you ill.
Wow.
But you can keep bacteria from ruining your day with four simple steps. Clean.
I'm waiting for the rinse cycle.
Separate. Cook.
Fire in the hole!
And chill.
We chipmunks are notoriously tidy.
Check your steps. The road trip to food safety starts at foodsafety.gov.
Catawba coming to the plate, needing to find two runs in three innings and try and do something that no other team has done this year, and that's beat Georgia College when the Bobcats are leading after four innings of play. After five innings of play, Georgia College is 22-0 in games where they've led after five. Grounded to third. One pitch, one out. One might ask how you go from 31-0 when leading after four to just 22-0 after leading after five. Well, games can be tied after four, or the Bobcats could have been trailing after four and then taking the lead in the fifth. 1-0 to Holly Chandler, the senior playing in her final NCAA tournament. That one's in there, 1-1. Ball and a strike. Carly Lewis still in the circle for Georgia College. Came in for Boyette in the third. That one in there, 1-2. Boyette had put runners on second and third with two outs back in the third when Carly Lewis came in and finished the inning, kept the Indians off the board. Outside, 2-2. Games at noon, 2:30, and 5. Tomorrow here in Dahlonega. Come out and join us at Haynes and Carolyn Hill Stadium. Expect some beautiful weather in Dahlonega. That one fouled off. Still 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, one out. Nobody on. 2-0 Bobcats of Georgia College. 2-2. Slapped foul down past the Indian bullpen. So the count is still 2-2. Bobcats with four hits. Catawba with three. The wind picking up severely from right to left. That one high in the air, but that one's going to be brought down by the wind. And making the play out in right is Snyder for out number two. I say the wind picks up. The flag, the American flag out in center field, was blowing up. Not out, up. That'll bring Lindsay Taylor to the plate with two down in the inning. Carly Lewis in the circle for the Bobcats. First pitch to Taylor. catches the zone for strike one. No balls and a strike. Here's the pitch to Lindsey Taylor. Caught the outside corner, 0-2. As the sun peaks behind the clouds, the wind blowing straight in from center now. Cold front from Canada moving through. The 0-2 swung on and missed, and the side retired in the fifth. Catawba's running out of time here to try and advance in the winner's bracket as Georgia College leads 2-0 after five innings of play. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional live from Dahlonega on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
Strength, power, and speed of elite student athletes will be on display. The sights, the sounds, the intensity of six NCAA championship competitions. It all comes down to this moment, and the winners take it all. Be there to share the experience with your family and friends. The 2016 NCAA Division II Spring National Championship Festival, May 16th through the 21st in Denver. Visit ncaa.com/tickets to score your championship experience today.
It's on us, all of us, to make sexual assault unacceptable.
Take the pledge at itsonus.org. And be a part of the solution.
We are challenging every Division II campus to take the pledge, to make a statement, and to make sexual assault unacceptable because
it's on us!
Kristen Brooks will lead things off for the Bobcats as they are two innings away from advancing in the winner's bracket here in Dahlonega. So that pitch is fouled over the press box for strike one. We're a little weary here at North Georgia when balls come flying toward the press box. Had a couple hit some windows here this year. Grounded to third. Misplaying it there is McCarthy. It will be an error charged to McCarthy. And a runner on first. There you see the official scoring on the score bug, E5. And Faith Flanders will get to step in with nobody out and a runner on. First pitch, low and inside is Ty Singer again. Pitching around Faith Flanders, who's 0-for-1 on the day with a ground out to first and a walk. Here's the 1-0. That one shot into right field. Coming on quickly, though, is Chandler, who will make the catch for out number one. Sliding back in safely is Brooks. So one down for a pinch hitter in Reagan Bray. Reagan on the year. Or rather, that's Hannah Corsi. I was looking at the wrong side. Hannah Corsi is the pinch hitter. Reagan Bray, number 16 for Catawba. So Hannah batting .260 on the year with a couple of home runs, 19 RBI. First pitch misses low, 1-0. She hasn't fared extremely well against the teams in this regional, has Hannah. She's just 1-of-8. She does have a home run and 4 RBI. She'll ground this one to the right side. Nice sliding play there by the second baseman in Turner to make the play for out number two. Runner advances to second, though, on the play. So Holland Corsi will now step in, the twin sister of Hannah. Here's the first pitch. High corner for strike one. Wind starting to blow in. Here's the 0-1, grounded right back to Tysinger. She gets a glove, tosses over, and makes the play for out number three. Bobcats leave one stranded in the sixth. We head to the bottom half. Georgia College 2, Catawba College nothing. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Softball Regional live from Dahlonega here on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
Na, 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 na. I love you so. I love you. I love you. La 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 la. La 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 la.
We're here.
Yay!
It's a short drive from your neighborhood to your naturehood. To find a neighborhood park or green space near you, visit discovertheforest.org.
Hey, Banks. Have a seat and let me make you uncomfortable. Up those grades, son, or the only position you'll be playing in college is sitting on me. You're still awake? Have a seat on old Mr. Bench. At least your buns will fall asleep.
Is this the one about the high school hotshot who gets benched in college?
Hey, man, T, move down.
It's a tearjerker!
For the Indians, it will be Turner Stinnard Shoemaker. Here in the sixth, the top part of the lineup. So if you're a Catawba fan, you've got to like your chances to put runs on the board here with the top part of your lineup. First pitch to Turner's popped up behind the shortstop Hall. She can't make a play on it. It's misfielded by the left fielder, Corsi. Will be a hit. And that brings Kristen Stinnard to the plate. Stinnard 1-for-2 on the day. First pitch ball. Turner 7-of-8 in stolen base attempts against Najafi, who, as I mentioned earlier, the best defensive catcher in Georgia College history. That one caught the zone 1-1. The error for Catawba does not come back to haunt them in the sixth, but they still trail 2-0. That one lined foul past third base, 1-2. The Indians trying to get something going here. The 1-2, breaking ball misses short, 2-2. Carly Lewis out of the wind, the 2-2. Shot through the left side and a base hit. Good effort there from the shortstop, Bailey Hall, but she was unable to get her glove on that one, the backhand. So two on and nobody out. Catawba threatening here with Catherine Shoemaker up to bat. Tying run stands on first. Georgia College has never lost a game when leading after five. Not this season, rather. First pitch outside, ball one. They're 22-0 when leading after five innings in 2016. Catawba trying to answer that and change that statistic. But they have not been very good in this scenario. That one out to left center. It will be, or right center rather. It'll be a base hit, and the bases are loaded with nobody out. Three singles to lead off the inning against Carly Lewis. And now Gina Jerome will step in. Catawba on the year after five innings, when trailing after five innings, just 2-12. So they have shown the ability to be able to come back and win. But in the 14 times that they've trailed after five innings, only two wins. And when trailing after six, they are 0-11. So they're going to look and try and tie this one up, because when they are tied after six innings, 7-2, when they're leading after six innings, 28-0 are the Indians, as Coach Gradecki. Finishes her mound visit. So Gina Jerome first pitch from Carly Lewis outside to Jerome. Georgia College had the bases loaded in the fifth. Were able to bring home one run, but they only had one out to work with once they had loaded the bases. Here's the 1-0, fouled off, 1-1. The Indians have all three outs to work with here in the inning. As many fans starting to file in for North Georgia and Young Harris. Approximate first pitch, 7-10. The 1-1 outside, 2-1. And Catawba is going to put a runner on first base for Shoemaker. It'll be number 10, Bethann Martin. Bethann, this is her 34th appearance in a game. She's 0-2 in stolen base attempts, but she has scored 10 times this year. Two balls and a strike to Jerome. Gina Jerome. A senior for Catawba. Now faces a 3-1 count. The 25th ranked and fourth seeded Catawba Indians trailing 2-0. The 3-1 pitch misses outside. Catawba's on the scoreboard. It's 2-1. And now with the tying run 60 feet away, it's Morgan Brand. The Jaffe's going to go out and have a word with Carly Lewis. Jamie Gradecki hasn't made a move to the bullpen. Nobody warming up in the bullpen for the Bobcats. Be interesting to see if Boyette comes back in at any point. So here's Bran. First pitch. Breaking ball in there for a called strike, 0-1. Still nobody out in the inning and the bases are full. The wind blowing straight in from center. Here's the 0-1. Outside, 1-1. The sun is out. There aren't any clouds anywhere close by that are going to get in front of the sun anytime soon. See some clouds out behind the trees, but none over the hill. 1-1. Popped up. Flanders dives, but can't make the catch. Good effort there by the first baseman, Flanders. 1-2. One ball, two strikes on Morgan Bran. Lewis deals outside, 2-2. Catawba's likely going to go to a pinch hitter for Tysinger, but Tysinger probably going to re-enter as the pitcher, just get somebody else at the plate. Here in the sixth with a 2-1 ball game. 2-2. Fouled off. Good breaking pitch there from Carly Lewis, who slowed that one way down. So it's still 2-2. Lewis with the 2-2. Taken toward right field. It's down for a base hit. One run's going to score. And we are tied 2-2. And another pinch runner. It'll be Leah Huggins. To run for Morgan Bran. And it'll be Ashley Wagner who is getting set to hit for Carly Tysinger. Wagner on the year, 233. She's got 5 doubles and 8 runs batted in. As you hear Jill Poole announce the subs, make sure that we got those up in the press box. So the game is tied at 2. Catawba has tied this thing up. Keep in mind, Georgia College has never lost this season after leading through 5 innings. Catawba looking to change that. First pitch to Wagner is inside, 1-0. Georgia College warming up a pitcher in the bullpen down the first baseline. Here's the 1-0. Pitch inside, and Najafi fakes back to third. It's Brooke Taylor who's warming up out in the pen. Two balls, no strikes. The wind in the pitch. That one caught the zone. 2-1. Carly Lewis trying to get out of this inning. Yet to get an out, though. And the game is tied. The bases are full. The 2-1 pitch. High and in, 3-1. Carly Lewis in the circle, trying to find an out for the Bobcats. Here's the 3-1. Miss low, and the game has gone to a Catawba lead. It is now 3-2. And Catawba again going to get someone different at the plate here. Hitting for Taylor Adams will be Delane Smith. And Coach Gradecki getting ready to make a change of her own. So it will be officially Delane Smith to hit, but Brooke Taylor coming in to pitch. We will take a break and introduce you to the new Bobcat pitcher right after this. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional live from Dahlonega here on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
Strength, power, and speed of elite student athletes will be on display. The sights, the sounds, the intensity of six NCAA championship competitions. It all comes down to this moment, and the winners take it all. Be there to share the experience with your family and friends. The 2016 NCAA Division II Spring National Championship Festival, May 16th through the 21st in Denver. Visit ncaa.com/tickets to score your championship experience today.
Georgia College making a move to the bullpen here in Dahlonega, trailing 3-2 now with the bases full and nobody out, going for the freshman from Powder Springs, Brooke Taylor, 7-1 on the year. This is her 22nd appearance, a 3.25 ERA, 60 and a third innings of work. She struck out 23, walked 24. Batters are 3.05 against her. And she will face Delane Smith to lead things off, the pinch hitter. Delane on the year, 3.09. Five doubles, two homers, 19 runs batted in. First pitch ball, 1-0. Five-six freshman from Harrison High School is Brooke. Down in Powder Springs, the 1-0. In the dirt, Najafi a little nonchalant there for a second. Jerome acted like she was going to come home, but ultimately did not. Now 2-0. Two balls, no strikes. Grounded down the third baseline. It is foul. Jerome Huggins, Wagner, all retreating 60 feet. Brooke Taylor, in her first NCAA tournament appearance of her career. Georgia College has been to the regional round 4 years in a row now, including a super regional appearance last year. Popped up and over the netting. It gets foul. 2-2. Regional champs in 2003-2006. Peach Belt Tournament champions in 2008. Ninth NCAA tournament appearance for Georgia College. Swung on and missed. One down now for Holly Chandler. And again, Nan Whitley is going to go to home plate umpire Jill Poole and make a change. Carly Tysinger going to go ahead and re-enter the game for Ashley Wagner. So Tysinger will be back in to pitch. So Holly Chandler will step in. 0-for-2 on the day. First pitch misses, 1-0. Bases loaded, one out in the inning. Georgia College is going to have an opportunity to answer in the seventh. The 1-0 pitch. Breaking ball caught the outside corner, 1-1. Infield playing in to try and prevent an Indian run here in the sixth. One run's going to be hard enough to get against one of the Southeast region's best pitchers, first team all region in Ty Singer. That one chopped right back to the pitcher, Taylor, who goes home to get the out, and Jerome goes down hard and she is hurt. Didn't quite see what happened, but there is a silence that has come over Haynes and Carolyn Hill Stadium, and they are looking at the leg of Gina Jerome. Gina, a senior shortstop for Catawba, and you would hate to see her softball career end in this way. She is going to get up. She's able to walk off with limited help, mostly under her own power. We hope that she is okay for sure. So Lindsay Taylor will step in. Scary moments there. Taylor 1-for-2 on the day. First pitch. Missed outside, 1-0. A ball and no strikes as the wind blows straight in from center. Blowing papers around in the press box, and a Jaffe down to third on that one. It's 2-0. Sliding back in safely is Huggins. Coach Whitley looking back into her dugout, watching the training staff work on Jerome. Grounded to first. Fielding and stepping on is Flanders for out number three. Catawba does damage, though, in the sixth. Bobcats are down to their final three outs. They need a run to tie and extend this game. It's 3-2 Catawba after six innings. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional live from Dahlonega on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
The NCAA Men's College World Series returns to Omaha, Nebraska. Catch the College World Series in VIP style with the NCAA Experience. Get exclusive access, premium tickets, and hospitality packages all from one source. The NCAA Experience. Visit NCAA.com/VIP to secure your VIP seats for the 2016 NCAA Men's College World Series, June 18th through June 29th at TD Ameritrade Park, Omaha in Omaha, Nebraska.
Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time. Celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes.
Great thing seeing Jerome back on the field as she went through her tests right in between those two innings and was able to re-enter the game after that scary situation there at home plate. It will be Caroline Snyder to lead things off as Morgan Brand going to re-enter the game, as is Taylor Adams for Catawba. So 9-1-2 for Georgia College. They need one to tie and extend this game, two to take a lead. Georgia College was 22-0 when leading after five innings. They're 0-15 when trailing after six. First pitch fouled off by Snyder. On the flip side, leading after six, Catawba 28-0. So 0-1 to Caroline Snyder. The 0-1 pitch missed outside. No, it didn't. Caught the outside corner. Georgia College faithful here did not like the call. The 0-2 pitch fouled off. Bernstein on deck. Snyder 1-for-2 on the day. She scored one of the two Bobcat runs. The 0-2 pitch fouled off again. Snyder stands back in, trying to put a base runner on for Georgia College. She represents the tying run. The 0-2 pitch taken through the left side. Nice play by Jerome to dive and make it, to keep it in the infield, but it is a single. I think the scary situation just scared Jerome a little bit. After that play, don't know if the adrenaline's kicked in and she's fine, or if she's hurting and playing through. You can't tell from that effort. Brings Bernstein up. First pitch. Catches the zone, 0-1. Tysinger trying to finish this one off. The pitch popped up behind third base. It's going to get down for a base hit. Good play there by Taylor on the funny hop to keep that one in front of her. 2-1 and nobody out. As it will be Shoemaker, or rather Bailey Hall, to step up to the plate now. Late inning dramatics here in Dahlonega. It was 2-0 in favor of the Bobcats before Catawba loaded the bases with nobody out, were able to push three across. Now Georgia College with 2-1 and nobody out, trailing by a run. First pitch, bunting is Bailey Hall. Fielding is Tysinger, over to first for the out. Runners advance to second and third on the play. And the tying run is 60 feet away for Abby Leroy. The go-ahead run, 120 feet away. First pitch to Leroy. Fastball in there for a strike. Tysinger just throwing it right in there. Sun beginning to set in right field. You see the long shadows being cast. The 0-1 swung on and missed, 0-2. The shadows from Tysinger and Turner and Jerome. The base runners, Bernstein. The three behind the plate here. Here's the 0-2. Check swing, did she go around? Gonna ask, and no she didn't, says Melvin Clark down at third. A ball and two strikes. The wind and the pitch. Grounded to short. Fielding is Jerome. And no play made as she acted like she wanted to come home. Elected to try and go to third, but the runner at second in Bernstein didn't go anywhere. The Jaffe will stand in. It's going to be ruled a fielder's choice officially. First pitch strike to the Jaffe. The game is tied at 3. The Jaffe to have a word with Gradecki. Ty Singer's thrown 103 pitches thus far. Pitch number 104 from the senior Ty Singer. Swung on and missed. On a pitch low and inside, 0-2. We're going to play a bottom of the seventh. As Catawba will have another go at it at the plate. The 0-2 pitch swung on and missed. Two down in the inning. Good pitch there from Ty Singer coming right at Najaffe, showing that she is not afraid. That brings Kristen Brooks up. Brooks is 0-3 today. First pitch right in there for a strike. Pops the glove of the catcher, Adams. The 0-1. Caught the outside corner, 0-2. Young Harris and North Georgia, approximate start time 7:10, although I believe that's going to end up being pushed back a touch. The 0-2. Fouled down the third base line. No balls, two strikes. Ty Singer winds and delivers. Outside, 1-2. A ball and two strikes. Carly Ty Singer strikes out. Kristen Brooks and the side retired. We're going to head to the bottom of the seventh here in Dahlonega. It's 3-3. Catawba needs a run to win. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional live from Dahlonega here on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
Todd's a great guy. I mean, look at him. What a sweetheart. Attaboy. Wait, Todd, what are you doing? How totally selfish and un-Todd-like of you. Come on, Todd. Come on, man.
What you've gained as a student will be just as important to you as what you did as a player. As long as you know that you made the effort to do the best of which you're capable, there's no failure. Success on three.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
We head to a bottom of the seventh inning here in Dahlonega. Catawba and Georgia College knotted up at three. It was 2-0 Georgia College as we went to the sixth before Catawba put three runs on the board to take the lead heading to the sixth. And then we went to the seventh and Georgia College tied it up. So that's where we stand. Bottom of the seventh inning. Catawba, three runs off seven hits. They've committed one error. Georgia College, three runs off six hits. They have not committed an error. First pitch is a strike to the top of the lineup for Catawba and Caroline Turner facing Brooke Taylor in the circle. The freshman Brooke Taylor in her first NCAA tournament appearance misses that one low, 1-1. Got all the way back to the backstop through the legs of Najaffe. 1-1. Here's the 1-1. High and outside, 2-1. Flanders playing in on the corner at first. Bailey Hall at short works her way over toward third base right before the pitch. There she moves again. You see her moving over as that pitch misses high, 3-1. Leroy at second. I don't think moves as much as Bailey Hall does at short. I'll watch it a little closer this time. In fact, she doesn't move at all. The 3-1. Caught the outside corner, full count. The outfield for Georgia College, playing it straight up. A little bit closer to the line in left field is Corsi. Then the right fielder, Snyder, in right. Payoff pitch. And quickly down the line is Caroline Turner. She didn't really give Jill Poole a chance to say anything as to whether or not it was a ball or a strike. Just went on down to first no matter what. So Stinnard at the plate. Tried to lay down a bunt in the first. And Turner was dead to rights on that one as it went right back to the pitcher, Boyette. She'll try and lay the bunt down there and foul it off. Game two is Young Harrison, North Georgia. The eighth-seeded Mountain Lions, the top-seeded Nighthawks, and fourth-ranked, in the nation. Low and outside, 1-1. As Georgia College is ready to play the bunt, Flanders and Brooks flying toward home. Second baseman Leroy over to first. Shortstop Hall to cover second. Swinging away there, grounded to third. Brooks fields, no play, nobody covering third. So 2-1 as Turner was unable to advance third. And Coach Whitley to re-enter Shoemaker into the game. The Nighthawks and Mountain Lions have made their way down to the field, preparing for the second game of our doubleheader. As Gradecki will go out and have a word with everybody for Georgia College. Here's where we stand. 3-3 is your score. Nobody out. The game-winning run stands on second. It's a very precarious situation for the freshman pitcher, Brooke Taylor. She has wins over Lincoln Memorial, Augusta, and Virginia State this season. But I doubt that a game has been as big as this one has for the freshman in this season. So Catherine Shoemaker will step in. 1 for 3 on the day. Stennard 3 for 4. Turner 2 for 2 with a couple of walks and a triple. Laying down the bunt nicely, Shoemaker. She throws over to first there, does the pitcher in Taylor for out number one. But now the game-winning run is just 60 feet away for Gina Gerone, who will step back into the batter's box. Georgia College gonna play in on the infield. Their only play will be to home, as they will try and keep this game alive and give themselves another chance. They're gonna walk Gerone. So it will be an intentional walk to Gina Gerone to go up against the first baseman, Morgan Brand, who is 1 for 3 so far today. So they're going to get the force out at home is what the idea is here. Make it a little bit easier to get an out at home instead of putting it in the eyes of home plate umpire Jill Poole to say whether or not the tag was applied in time. You just have to get the ball home and touch the plate. So the bases are full for Morgan Brand. Again, 1 for 3 on the day. Tysinger yet to come out to the on-deck circle. She is on deck. First pitch to Brand, breaking ball low, 1-0. Now Tysinger emerges from the dugout. A ball and no strikes. Some late inning drama in Dahlonega. Up in the air to right field. Snyder, Fields, play at the plate. Here comes the throw. Nice throw from Najafi. Not going to be able to make the tag. And Catawba will win game one of the 2016 Southeast Regional here in Dahlonega. We will take a break. When we return, we will wrap things up. You're watching the 2016 NCAA Division II Southeast Regional from Dahlonega. Catawba wins game one 4-3 here on the Nighthawk Sports Network.
Strength, power, and speed of elite student athletes will be on display. The sights, the sounds, the intensity of 6 NCAA championship competitions. It all comes down to this moment, and the winners take it all. Be there to share the experience with your family and friends. The 2016 NCAA Division II Spring National Championship Festival, May 16th through the 21st in Denver. Visit ncaa.com/tickets to score your championship experience today. Strength, speed, and power of elite student athletes will be on display. The sights, the sounds, the intensity of NCAA championship action. It all comes down to this moment. Only the best teams advance to this level. Be there to share the experience with your family and friends. The 2016 NCAA Women's College World Series, June 2nd through the 8th at ASA Hall of Fame Stadium, OGE Energy Field in Oklahoma City. Visit ncaa.com/WCWS to secure your championship experience today.
Back here in Dahlonega, let's take a look at that final play here on our NCAA replay. The sack fly works to perfection. I think that the throw from Snyder is a good throw. It's just a little bit short and off to the right, making Najafi come off and make the catch off the plate. Otherwise, I think the tag gets laid down in time, and we might be in extra innings. Your final score, 4-3 here in Dahlonega. Your winning pitcher. Unofficially. Well, officially would be Ty Singer. Ty Singer with the complete game will get the win and improve to 32-9 on the year. Catawba advances to play the winner of our next game at 12 noon tomorrow here in Dahlonega. Georgia College will drop into the loser's bracket and will take on the loser of our next game in an elimination game at 2:30 tomorrow. Stay tuned for game two of the Southeast Regional live from Dahlonega coming up in a little over 30 minutes. Expect around 7:30 to be the start time of game number two of the Southeast Regional, but if you stay right here, we'll come back live when it's time for the game. That'll do it for game one. Your final score, Catawba 4, Georgia College 3, here in game one of the Southeast Regional. For the Nighthawk Sports Network, I'm Walker McCreary, signing off from Dahlonega. Again, Indians 4, Bobcats 3.